Hello. So today I wanted to review the Kratky methods that we set up. We set up three different ones. This is the one we put outdoors. So we used an all-in-one aero garden. This is about $25 per bottle. And we added it up to 2.5 EC as a set it and forget it method so that we wouldn't have to add any nutrients the entire plant's life, or at least until it got larger. And then we could retest if it drank a significant amount. And with hydrogen peroxide as a substitute to HydroGuard. So we added about 2 milliliters in the beginning. You add about 2 milliliters every time you water, as same thing with hydrogen peroxide. So I used a pineapple in a non-food grade bucket just to see if it would work out in the desert in the 110 degree heat. And I wanted to film today just because it's crazy that it's raining out right now. It's been raining a lot more here, and it's dropped the temperature down to 79, and it's been about 100 every day to 110 here. And in the sunlight, that gets up to like 120, 130. It gets really, really hot in the sunlight. So, this is actually the greenest the yard has been in a very long time. So, you can see there's a lot of like algae forming. The cracking method is where we rely on the roots to go lower in the bucket for them to come in contact with air so that the plant doesn't drown. Because the reason hydroponic plants don't drown is because they have access to oxygen. And there's oxygen in water because H2O, but usually not enough for a plant's entire life cycle. And the algae will consume the oxygen. So usually you don't want that as well. But this plant is alive and green and doing well. And I've seen this work for people outdoors and stuff in a bunch of different climates. So I'm trying it outdoors here. Even though it's a non-food grade bucket, I just want to see how well it works. And I think it's going well, and I would do this outside more. And I think I'm going to try this outside more with like loofahs, because I've grown some sponges in the past and I'd like to grow some more sponges, and I'd like to see if it would work well in this climate and just maybe some other things just to use up some of my old plant nutrients and experiment more for you guys. So we're going to go inside and review the one in the windowsill that has no LED above it and how that one's done and been doing, and the one under the LED lights and the 8x8 tent. So the outdoors one was with tap water. This one was with reverse osmosis filtered water, also with the hydrogen peroxide as a substitute for HydroGuard, and with the all-in-one aero garden $25 a bottle nutrients that we added up to 2.5 as a set it and forget it method. In the windowsill with no LEDs above them, in the aloe and overgrown broccoli room. Just as a experiment to see if we could get it to grow in a windowsill with low maintenance. It's starting to droop, which is not the greatest. And I've had to add some water to it. So it ended up being a little higher maintenance than I would have liked to, or than with air bubbles, because I have an arugula with air bubbles that I didn't have to water as frequently, hasn't drooped at all. And that's just because this is a bit of a cheaper method to do it with. So it takes a little bit more patience with and practice, which I haven't done a lot. So you could definitely get better results than this, and I would recommend this in a windowsill. It's a good set it and forget it method. We use perlite as a substitute instead of clay pebbles because perlite's significantly cheaper. You can get a bag of perlite for like $17 that'll fill up like 20 net pots, where clay might be $100 and you only fill up like 6 net pots. So you can see where the water level is at. This is a food grade black bucket, but you don't need a water level indicator. You could just do this in a bucket. This is just because I use these buckets for my deep water culture setups. But I would still like to do this more in the windowsill just so that I don't have to use LEDs and for some short growing plants that take 40, 60 days, like lettuces and arugulas. And again, it's a great use of my extra plant nutrients that I have. I do think it would be a pain, and it is going to be a pain, to clean the perlite out and get all the dead roots out when the plants are done, which I'll show the third plant and how that one went, where the clay is far easier to clean when you're done and you want to like reuse it and recycle the plant. So I haven't experienced cleaning the perlite yet, so I'll let you know how that goes. But with the clay, I just end up washing it out and getting the dead roots out, and it's fairly simple, and I'm able to reuse it. So we're gonna go check on the third plant and let you know how that one went. So now we're in the 8x8 tent. This is all deep water culture with air bubbles being pumped into the bottom of the bucket. So there's no air stone. It's being pumped directly into the bottom of the bucket. And I don't change reservoirs in any of my buckets with the air bubbles and temperature controlled. I think that we're able to maintain a pretty good environment and it does well for most of my plants. So I like set it and forget it and less maintenance and less work involved in plants. And deep water culture turns out to be less work than Kratky because I don't have to worry about if the plant is drooping or getting enough oxygen or am I drowning it or is there bacteria growing in the bucket, because it's harder for bacteria to grow in a moving environment. So the bubbles keep the environment moving and it's harder for stuff like that to grow and fester. But the bubbles do get annoying and the pumps do get loud. So Kratky is nice because it's really quiet. But we have the last Kratky method we tried out here. And this was the gourmet lettuce. This one ended up dying. It was doing fine. This is a gourmet lettuce that's alive and we let it get very tall, for example. And then here's another one that's bolted and is flowering at the top. Even though it really shouldn't be, since this is a short cold day tent and these are long day plants and they shouldn't really flower under a short cold day. But they're getting overgrown. So sometimes we'll get a little bit of a difference there. Like this arugula is a long day plant. It shouldn't flower under 12 hours, but it's very overgrown, as you can see, and we harvest from it all the time. And I'm letting it flower a little bit to get some seeds off of it. But yeah, sometimes we'll get some long day plants that are actually flowering in a short cold day environment. And yeah, I never watered this one. I didn't add any water to it at all. I might have needed to. Let's see if the roots are there. Oh, they fell off in the bucket. I don't really want to touch this nutrient water, but there they are. So you can see there's a lot of perlite in the bucket, and I'm just thinking that it's probably going to be a bit of a pain. So I'm probably going to use clay more often in the future. I just want to test it out for you guys. And yeah, like I said, the Kratky method takes more of like maintenance and an eye for it. And not that you can't get a perfect set it and forget it setups. I've seen good set it and forget it setups, but some are better than others with different plants and require different amounts of maintenance and checking. So that's why I just like the deep water culture and bubbles, and that's why I'm going to mainly stick to it. And I'm going to do some Kratky outdoors and in the windowsill a little bit with some excess buckets. And maybe if perlite's not too tough to wash, maybe I'll keep trying perlite with it or a different grow media. This one was with the reverse osmosis filter water. We used HydroGuard this time instead of the hydrogen peroxide, and we didn't add any water to it its entire life. It started it at 2.5 EC. Like I said, we probably should have added some water to it at some point, and that would probably have kept it alive. Again, with that one, we did use the $25 all-in-one Aero Garden nutrient bottle, where normally for all my plants, I use a veg bloom bundle, which I will show and talk about more at the end of the video. So some people like MHP Gardener here on YouTube have some great set it and forget it Kratky setups for this like 6x6 table top that he creates, where you put lettuces in and set it and forget them for like 30 to 40 days and you don't have to water them that whole time. And he was a big inspiration for me when I was getting into hydroponic growing about 4 years ago. And it's been a couple of years since he posted, but a lot of his content is still very good around Dutch buckets, using perlite, cleaning perlite, different types of hydroponic setups. And so I really recommend his channel and I like his channel a lot. And then Mike VanDuzee or VanDuzee, I'm so sorry. I'm not going to say that correctly. I see he does a lot of Kratky outdoor setups with algae. And it works out great because algae can be nutrients for plants. And if they get enough oxygen, they can be just fine and work well. And those guys are far more specialized in their areas and are better in those areas if you want to learn more about that topic and Kratky method. But I'm predominantly deep water culture and I'm not going to be as professional in the Kratky area. So I just want to point them out because they're going to be better teachers than me. So this arugula has never drooped, and this is the one I was talking about that I watered less frequently. We just watered it recently though, so water is full. But yeah, I've never had it droop, and it is older than the one in the windowsill. The one in the windowsill I need to go clip so that it stops drooping. I just wanted to show it drooping so that I could demonstrate that level of difficulty sometimes occurring. And I don't know whether the plant is drowning right now or not. So I don't know whether I should add more water or if I should have it get more air. My guess is it needs more water because the perlite at the top is drying out, and that I should submerge it in more water. But I also need to prune a lot of those leaves off and defoliate that because it's having trouble hydrating and it might die off and is going to struggle. So I know someone might say something about that. I just wanted to show it drooping just as a demonstration. So I defoliated and took off a bunch of those leaves that were drooping since I obviously want this plant to survive. And then I added some water straight on top of their rootstocks to wet the perlite a little bit. Since if you're going to do this method, that's what I would recommend to do to keep the plant alive if you're struggling with what I'm struggling with it. And last thing, with the temperatures, this room is usually around 80 to 85 degrees. Right now it's just 75 because it's raining outside. My grow tent in there is usually around 70 degrees, and outdoors is usually around 100. Just to give some different perspective on the temperature ranges with the buckets, I recommend 70 degrees for the water temperature in the bucket. Temperature is important, not just for the water. Like in the strawberry tent, we try to keep the temperature around 65 to 70 to make them think that it's spring or fall, to make them think it's a certain type of year, to get them to flower. So it's not just for the bacteria growth and for water maintenance to keep them around 70. It also can be to tell them what time of year it is. And most plants thrive in around 70 to 75. So as always, I will have links down below to all the hydroponic gear that we use in our setup. We have discount codes for grow lights, grow tents, and grow tent kits. And if you hover over the corner in the Amazon page, it will show you a little description of what we use each product for. And if you want more of our content, we have our hydroponic plants playlist. If this is on YouTube or Facebook, you can click it on YouTube. We have what YouTube thinks is best for you, and you can subscribe for more. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.